All right, I am here with the newest Web3 duo, NFT creator economy duo. We got Mo.
Yo, what's going on, everyone?
We got Navin.
What's good, everyone?
And we have Mazin as well. Say what's up.
Hey.
There you go.
Took me a second. Hey, how's it going?
hey. And listen, you know, I thought it'd be a really cool idea for us to chat about all three things. Web3, NFTs, creator economy, and, you know, if there's some leftover stuff, we can hit on some hot topics. I wanted to ask you guys, though, about this Rich Kids NFT, because we're actually in a group. We're in a group thread. All right. I don't know where it came up. I think Navin said.
I'm pretty sure
there was Rich Kids.
Yeah.
It was a Rich Kids NFT. Yo, I think this is gonna go bananas.
Yeah.
I was like gonna pick up my kids. I'm like, I don't know if you guys are in. I'm in. I can't go. I'm on a flight. You were somewhere. I'm like, okay, I can pick up a whole bunch of them. All right. I go off. I buy six of these Rich Kids NFTs. Okay. Yeah. I don't even know how much I drop. A lot of ETH on this. And then recently, I don't know what happened. Did it get rug pulled?
So I was interested in this because we had bought this. And first of all, to preface this, I was just bullish on Rich the Kid. Anyways, I go on the Discord. I'm like, you know, we haven't heard about this for a little while. Rich the Kids, what's popping with it? I go on the Discord and I'm looking around and people, I'm seeing angry people and all kind of comments. I look on the right side and you know where you can see the leaderboard. Not the leaderboard, but the roles. I'm noticing like, the devs aren't there. The original owners of the Discord are not in there anymore. So I started doing some digging. I go on OpenSea and, you know, bad news is the floor's at zero.
The floor's at zero.
Literally at zero. So
Oh my God.
I immediately started doing more digging. I hop on Twitter, hop on the Discord. And the day after, I see Rich the Kid buy a Bored Ape. So I'm intrigued. I'm like, okay, so he bought a Bored Ape. And I go in the comments because, you know, Twitter comments, Instagram comments are the best place to live. And people are going off like, how could you rug pull your own project? How can you afford this Bored Ape? Because I'm trying to think, okay, maybe they took the millions of dollars and just ran.
Oh,
and now he's buying Bored Apes. Now, I don't want to say that and make accusations, if you look at it from our perspective, zero floor, Discord's dead, people are pissed, absolutely no value utility.
So I don't know what your thoughts are on this because
Did you even know?
This is news to me right now.
Oh no.
This is breaking news.
This is breaking
news. I'm holding like some illegitimate like rich kids. Like I just have now literally just pictures that were worth nothing of these kids.
I echo his comments. If the Discord devs are gone and these guys buying a Bored Ape, like where'd he get the extra cash flow, that Ethereum cash flow?
So this is actually a great topic. This is a great scenario because I believe that 99% of NFT projects will happen. It's going to go to zero, right? Because most people will realize that it not only does it not have utility, but also there's nothing really behind it. There's no community. There's nothing really behind it. There's no narrative. There's no story. There's nothing. And, you know, we're in a group chat. We're always figuring out, okay, what's a new NFT project? And we're all saying, I think this has value. I think this. But at the end of the day, that's what everyone asked me. They're like, what gives it value? We bought this Rich Kids. Why did we buy it? Let's just like go back for a second. Why did we buy this Rich Kids NFT? Why did we buy it?
The exact reason for me was seeing him on Twitter. And correct me if I'm wrong, the first ever rapper NFT. I could be completely wrong, but I'm pretty sure it was.
One of the first.
Yeah. And with on this scale is what I'm saying, like a massive community, 10,000 rich kids. I was like, yo, let's take a risk. Rapper verified, millions of followers, everyone knows his name.
Yeah.
Let's try it.
That's why I got in is because, you know what, you said, okay, let's take a risk. I'm fine with it. Let's take a risk. What were your thoughts?
Usually what I do is I go straight to the website to see like, you know, like you gotta understand, like why. So, like you talk about, there's no utility. I thought they actually did have utility. They if you go on,
they were supposed to do.
If you go on their on the website, I can't really pull it up now. I'm trying to figure it
there
out.
There was like Rolexes, Lamborghinis. There was things promised, and maybe they did give those away. I'm not sure.
But it was also part of their like his album release, wasn't it?
There were supposed to be things built in where I think they were flying a certain Rich Kid members out to be in the music video or something like that,
and then
credits on the album. So there was like potential utility, but I just don't think it was realized.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, exactly. That's kind of a little.
So what do you say to people when they're like, I don't understand where the value is in NFTs? Now, I can answer this, but I want to know from you, how do you position this to people?
I could start off. You can I mean, like, for example, if we're using like a musician in this instance, like you could be launching an album, right? And then let's say your cover art for the album is the NFT, right? But you holding this token, it allows you to, for example, get access to his potential concert, some royalties from the album. So that's like incentivizes you to potentially own that NFT because you forever will be getting. Imagine Drake has like Certified Lover Boy as an NFT, and then if you had that one of 10,000 and how many sales he makes it, you're getting that royalty. I mean, that's huge, that's big. I mean, there's like obviously like merchandise involved in that. It's just like, it's kind of like you have to think outside the box of how can I, as a musician, for example, we're using music in this example, to unlock the potential for. Essentially, like you're investing into that artist. That's kind of what you're doing. I'm using that as an example. Do you have anything else?
I want to add to something he said, and I'll answer your question. Maz, if you have a second, if you can pull up on Twitter or Instagram, I think his name is 3LAU. It's like 3 Lau. Yeah. Have you seen the artist?
Oh, like,
so he's doing like,
I call him Blau.
Blau. Okay, Blau. So he's doing the royalty stuff, which I've tried to get in, but it always sells out. Where
no, he's like an OG.
Yeah, NFT he's one of the OG musician. Guys, but he's building it where artists can now monetize their songs through NFTs and create royalties for the fans, which I think is the next layer of what's going to happen in the web and Web 3.0. But going back to
How do you explain NFTs to the disbelievers, to the non-believers?
Okay, so first the question about like the first question we had is we always got to go back to Bored Ape, the community. I feel like it all comes down to the community, like what they're actually doing, and like. It's really tough to say this, but even when you look up on these certain projects and you look at the creators and the owners, half the time they're anonymous. You don't actually know who the people are behind it. And that's like the trickiest part. But you can, I always tell people, you have to dive into NFTs. You have to dive into Discords before you can understand. You can't just understand it from the outside looking in. You got to see the Discord, see the craziness that's happening and try to understand, okay, where's the utility and roadmap going? You know what I mean? I think that's the biggest thing. Explain an NFT, bro. It's literally you're just buying a digital asset. Take whatever you want, turn it digital, and sell it.
Yeah.
And it's either going to have tremendous value.
Yeah.
Or it'll never have value.
But let's just chat quickly about the idea of the community, because many of the communities sit on Discord, and I don't know about you, but when you know we all got stuff to do, when we can't be in a Discord all day long.
Yeah.
And when you have thousands of people in a Discord. It's impossible to keep track of what's happening. Like you just go in and you're like, oh my God, like the world just blew up, and you can't, you're just like so disengaged because it's just, there's so much going on. I don't know if you can create a great community off Discord.
I kind of disagree with that.
Okay.
Because
we're going to say the same thing.
Maybe, but so when I first joined Discord, I thought I had similar thoughts and feelings. For at first, I thought the platform was just weird. I was like, how the hell do you? It just looked weird. And then when I jumped into Discord groups or servers, I realized that there's a lot of chatter. Things are going nuts, and I'm like, what the hell's going on? But as soon as I just typed a question, I got an answer, and it was kind of like, I don't know who that person was. And all of a sudden, you type another question, someone else answers you. So. In a way, what you're forming is more of a, like, there are individuals who do live on Discord who will always try to help you in that sense. I've never been in a Discord group and then I threw a question in or comment or something and without somebody actually giving you a comment back. So I feel like, yes, it is very crowded. Yes, it looks extremely like intimidating almost, like, should I even drop this, like, whatever. But it kind of reminds me of the old school, like, when like, you know, Messenger and like MSN, like first, like, you know, when you just wanted to just chat with people and say whatever.
Totally.
That's exactly what it is. It's like very raw, unfiltered, and everybody's there to, in a way, help each other. I mean, I would also add a lot of people are there to make quick flips.
That's what I hate.
Which is kind of the narrative that a lot of NFTs like are not going to succeed. However, it's because it stems from people are making... they want to make quick cash. Anything else to add?
I just think to add to that, like, again, I hate going back to the only example in the world, but Bored Ape, like, they're literally having the yacht party. NFT NYC. I think that's like a good example of what's happening. Like you're seeing brands like also Cool Cats, obviously this Bored Apes doing their yacht parties and whatnot, but NFTBA is another one. That's like this basketball association, NFT Basketball Association, where they actually hosted a basketball tournament already this summer in Venice. And they're starting to come where they're taking the Discord and they're putting that into real life events. I think that's where I'm more bullish on.
Yeah.
Because like you said, I'm not going to sit on Discord, bro. But you tell me there's a basketball event or there's a pop-up shop for this and that. Like, you know, that's cool.
Yeah. I think what you're going back to is the idea of offline, you know, utility.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
Yes, it's nice, yeah. All the, you know, what's happening in Discord. But exactly. Really, at the end of the day, in my mind, like a true community is built around people ultimately having relationships and trust. Yeah. And you could do that in digitally a little bit. But, meeting up in real life is where you actually build a true value.
Yeah. Well, imagine going to NFT NYC and you see this profile picture. You've seen it for a year. And you finally meet that person. There's a Bored Ape, but then you meet them in person. Like, that's a different type of connection. Yeah. It can't happen anywhere else.
Yeah.
You know, then you build that trust. You build that community.
Yeah.
Takes it to the next step.
Hey, Mazin, do me a favor. Can you pull up the fact that there's a huge announcement today around Starbucks in their Q4 earnings call, talking about the fact that their CEO saying
Starbucks.
You
typed in Timbits.
Oh, hey. We can talk.
He's hungry.
We can talk about Timbits in a little bit. But Starbucks announcing in their Q4 earnings that they are getting into blockchain and other sort of Web3, elements and thinking about the rewards program. So I want your quick reaction of Starbucks getting into the NFT game.
We just saw McDonald's get into it.
Yeah, man.
It's, I think it's a smart move. It's coming in full force. Every brand's going to utilize this. I think it's a smart choice for their loyal customers to give them a taste of the NFT space.
The biggest and smartest brands are moving, and we're literally watching it firsthand.
Yeah, yeah.
There's nothing else to say. Like, if you know what you're doing, you're coming into Web 3.0.
Like, we talked about Nike too. Like, they're not Nike's in it yet, but they
think about how many are building that we just haven't heard, that are just waiting for that moment to strike and come out.
I mean, we've already seen it in Roblox, like in a metaverse. That, you saw big brands in that space. But now in the metaverse, like you're able to essentially like buy digital assets in the metaverse. Like that's what's gonna happen in Decentraland. Like I'm gonna look at your swagger, like Nike little shoes that you're wearing.
I saw Nike has put together a whole bunch of patents in order to
Crypto Kicks.
Yeah, digital sneakers, right?
Yeah, so like Crypto Kicks is like, yeah, they're, if you buy a sneaker, you'll get a digital NFT of it. And they're trying to build in like the technology where like, if I have a digital NFT and Mo has a digital NFT, we can breed our sneakers together to create one new sneaker. And apparently they will make that sneaker in real life and you'll have a one-on-one.
Yeah.
On the blockchain and in real life.
Yeah.
If you think about that, that's a whole new way to interact with blockchain.
Well, that's the thing. I think like a lot of people are trying to bridge both worlds, the real world and the metaverse world. It's the only way. I know. Mazin
is struggling.
I don't think the article is up.
No. They just announced it. NFT. They didn't actually say NFT. They just said that they're experimenting with.
Gotcha.
They're going to experiment with blockchain in order for to get their rewards program. Hey,
it's the dark web, Zorin.
It's the dark web, man. No, it's in there.
It's still early.
Yeah, it's just if you look up Starbucks, Starbucks blockchain, I think that's probably the best.
Yeah, going back to my point about the real world application with the digital asset, it's kind of like, you know, like we're seeing like, you know, somebody who's extremely vocal, like Gary Vee with his VCon. His doodles. In a way, they're not pieces of art. They're not like a Monet or like
crazy piece
of art. But it's about the IP that's unlocking the real world application, and also like the digital asset of it. That, you know, so many people made so much, you know, cash or like, you know, Ethereum from it. So, what's your take about that whole Starbucks thing and kind of like that whole real world?
I think Starbucks getting into it is is super savvy. Like, every brand should be getting into this space for sure. I think Starbucks has an amazing opportunity because they're a company that you interact with every single day. It's not art. It's not like,
is
you know,
it,
something
by the way?
Hang.
Is this it?
What's yeah, that? Yeah, this is it. Yeah, that's blockchain-based cross-brand rewards.
Yeah, so yeah. I think, you know, being able to take, you know, their reward system and being able to use it for other things, you know, other purchases and using it for other transactions,
yeah.
I think is really savvy. And I think, they're not doing it for art. They're doing it for actual utility, yeah. Which I come back, like, you know why I'm so obsessed with this? It's because I actually don't care about the art piece. I care about people using NFTs for actual utility.
Yeah.
And that's what I'm most excited about. So to me, this is a great idea. And the fact that they're so, like, Starbucks is a financial services company. Starbucks, their rewards card, I don't even know how much cash they have in their rewards, but it's like they have like billions of dollars in it.
Yeah, probably billions.
It is used more than people's actual like bank cards.
Yep.
I mean, it's ridiculous. So to me, them getting into the space is super exciting.
I feel a lot of people are starting to do that. Like, again, VCon, not great art.
Totally.
But the real world.
Huge utility.
Yeah, huge utility in the real world. I mean, Bored Ape, in a way, a lot of people went in for the art, but now they're looking in more from like, how can we apply it to the real world application?
Yeah.
I feel like that's only way. Like, I know in the metaverse, like Decentraland or Sandbox, like there's things to do there, like whether it's like concerts or whatever, you can buy stuff. But like you said, eventually we all have to come together, which is why NFT NYC was like a great kind of testament to the
what's
whole
happening.
NFT space.
Yeah. Well, listen, on the topic of Starbucks, Mazin, can you pull up the Justin Bieber Timmy's? what's it called, by the way? Justin?
It's called Tim Biebs.
Yeah, Tim Biebs.
Tim Biebs. Listen, are you guys into Tim Biebs?
No, we need it. First of all, we need multiple orders of it. And we got to put one box on ice each.
Ooh!
Put it in a Ziploc bag, you know, keep it locked away somewhere.
Absolutely.
That's exclusive. Look at this guy,
oh,
man.
Look at that guy. Tim Horn.
And there's two new flavors, I think, right?
I love Tim. Yeah. Yo, let me tell you about this. I love Justin Bieber. Let's put it on record. I love Justin Bieber. I don't know why Justin Bieber gets a lot of hate. People are embarrassed that, you know, Justin Bieber is Canadian or his music or whatnot. I love Justin Bieber.
Yep.
And I love this collaboration between Tim Hortons and Justin Bieber because to me, Tim Hortons is almost irrelevant. So to partner with somebody with relevance, to me, this is the Kanye gap.
This is huge.
Yeah, you're
Justin
right.
Justin Bieber
gap,
and Tim Hortons is Kanye and the gap.
Yeah, I think I agree with that.
I can't wait to see the merchandise that's coming out.
I know.
Yeah. Well, what's going to happen?
Well, he's also a big hockey fan, too. So I think the two main things he's always talked about from Canadian culture is hockey and Tim.
And Timmy.
Or Tim Horans.
It's nice to see that he's doing that, to be honest. And he's like a huge advocate.
Yeah.
Well, Mazin, what do you think about the Bieber Tim's collabo?
Love it. Can't wait to be the first one to eat it.
Birthday cake waffle.
chocolate. Yeah.
You saw those flavors right there?
Look pretty good.
But I think this is a realization, going back to the creator economy, that you're going to see a lot more of these collaborations of traditional institutions collaborating with creators. And Justin Bieber is a creator. Obviously, he's like a celebrity creator. But you're going to see more and more of these collabos happening. Like, I just think that the old school brands like the Tim Hortons, the Gaps, like the GEs of the world, I feel like they're gonna get into this space a lot more and connect with the youth, because to be honest with you, most young people that I know, they don't drink Timmy's, they drink Starbucks.
They drink Starbucks, yep.
I don't know why.
It's the sugary drinks, bro. It's those sugary drinks.
I know.
It's the downfall.
I don't know.
but it's true, though. It's exciting to see who's going to come in next, to be honest.
Well, Bieber, to me, why does, by the way, Bieber get all the hate? I don't know why. Why does Bieber get the hate?
I think there's a lot of things. I also personally love him. Him and Drake, like, two icons for me. And all of Justin's songs are hits. I don't care if we're talking about the old stuff or the new stuff. They're all bangers.
Yeah.
I just think people hate for no reason, man. Like, I think he went off. He had his own, some mental stuff that he talked about and touched on. He got tatted up. People didn't like that. people have their own opinions, but like, look at this dude, bro.
I don't think he's hated on these days. Is he?
I'm sure there's always hate.
I'm sure there is.
Yeah, I mean, like, I don't see it like in the media, but I don't know. For me, yeah, Justin Bieber. You know,
I think he's dope.
When you think of pop artists, he's one
no, absolutely,
top.
And I think he's super talented. I'm gonna go back to Madsen because Madsen, you know, you're an artist. Like Bieber is super, super talented. Can we all agree on that?
I definitely agree with that. Yeah. I don't have much else to comment on. You guys are already saying
mic drop, yeah.
Everything, but yeah, like I don't think he's really being hated on. I don't know where you're getting that.
Yeah.
Well, earlier though.
Earlier it was all jokes. Like
yeah, earlier definitely. The last like X amount of years has been crazy hate.
It's but like,
last
so did like you know, back, right?
Yeah. You know the tipping point that went from like hating Bieber to not hating Bieber. It was the roast
oh.
that he had.
Oh yeah.
That was an epic roast.
That was one of the best roasts I've seen. And then I think after that point, to me, Justin Bieber was like certified. Like
he's back up.
Like you're good. Yeah, you're like
yeah, that's a good point.
You're official now.
I think almost child celebrity went through that stage.
Yeah,
right?
A lot of
like even Miley Cyrus. There's a phase where
Miley. Yeah.
Yeah, there was a phase where she was being hated on, and then now.
Nobody cares about.
Nobody. Yeah, nobody's really saying that. So.
Okay, so I want to ask you guys because, you know, we talk a lot about NFTs and what NFT projects are circulating in your own mind. I know, like, you know, even for In the Lab, and I know we were chatting a little bit about that. I have an NFT project that I want to pitch to you guys.
All right.
Live right now?
And I think it's going to... Yeah, I don't know if I should do it now, but I want to hear. I am going to do it now, but I want to hear your guys' you know, in your brain, your NFT projects.
I know you have a. I don't know if you're talking about that now. I know you have.
I
don't
hear. No. I mean, listen. I want to hear yours.
Okay.
Okay.
This is my.
I'm excited. Right.
This is my NFT projects. This is my NFT project. The NFT project is called Aunties and Uncles. Basically, it's images. It's 10,000 uniquely designed. Images of just, you know, those aunties and uncles that use hat, you know, you go to your house parties and then, you know, all the kids were in the basement and then you have the aunties and uncles, you know, have some of the bigger aunties and some of the bald uncles and like the glasses and, you know, the ones that sort of mispronounced who you are. They're like, oh, hey, Ravi, how are you? Like, how's school doing? You know, like we all know 10,000 aunties and uncles. And I just feel like it would really resonate with like our community, you know, like brown community. I think it would be really dope.
Can I ask you something?
Yeah.
Is this a real idea?
No, I swear to God.
Because I really want to like invest and be a part of it.
Okay, you're in? Are you there?
I'm in.
Are you cool?
Because you know the utility we could build would be hilarious. Yeah, we could do.
Okay, so are we in? Are we going to build this Aunties and Uncles NFT project?
Whenever I think it's the stupidest idea, that's when I think it's the most brilliant idea.
Yes.
I actually think it's hilarious, bro. The way you describe that, I'm picturing like some of the artwork and some of the pictures.
Well, yeah, you think about all the aunties and uncles that you know and then just like,
We could literally model it after the ones we know
and
let them become famous.
Exactly. You could have the smiley auntie with the short hair and you could have, you know what I mean? You could have all sorts of aunties.
The cool aunties.
Yeah, like... the cool aunties, the modern aunties, the cool uncles, the potbelly uncles.
I don't think this should be shared on social media because I actually think this is a great idea.
Okay.
And I would love to build this out somehow. Because I actually think it has, legs. Growing up Indian, I think we understand this.
Yeah. Are you in?
I'm in.
Our co-collaborator on the Aunties and Uncles, dropping it here first.
I'm in.
Okay, well, we might get some things together to drop Aunties and Uncles. And by the way, do we need utility on this, or can this just be like a piece of art? Can we just say to everyone, because I don't want a Discord that says floor, like you, where's the roadmap? Hey, this is just like us commemorating aunties and uncles.
The greatest aunties and uncles of our time.
Yeah.
I think
utility comes later.
Yeah.
Okay.
Do what Bored Ape did.
Okay,
they utility. Didn't have utility.
Utility could be like slaps, cleaning up your room, doing the laundry. we could really build some.
But yeah, anyways, that's my project. Obviously, with other things, like I want to be able to figure out.
Man.
I truly, like, you know, with what we're doing with DMSK and stuff like that, like I haven't seen an NFT project with e-commerce because there's like I'm getting too deep into this, but the idea of being anonymized.
Yeah.
But... the fact is you still need people's addresses to deliver them stuff.
Yep.
So I think there's got to be some sort of development where you can still keep somebody anonymous and still know what their home address is so that you can deliver it to them without...
That's interesting.
Without doxing them in some sort of
way.
You know what I mean? That's what I'm trying to figure out. Anyways, that's just... That's another piece, but...
That's actually really interesting. I wonder if that'll come soon. I don't know if you're going to tell your idea, but I'm leaving that to you later. We've been talking about this for almost a year now. There's a lot of, and I want to get into like these projects, and I want to be able to build our own.
Yeah.
Because I just think there's so much promise, and I think going through this for the last year, we could build something special. Now, I'm not saying it's aunties and uncles. It could be anything. I'm just saying in general. In the lab, we talked about coins. Even you guys were going to do a coin. We're finally circling back. Now it's time because we're starting to see like what's happening, and we understand it so much better. So 2022 is the year of the In the Lab coin, which is going to unlock a crazy amount of utility.
Let's go.
And on top of that, and we talked about this also, Creator Classic, we're going to be building out NFTs. So we're going to be building out NFTs for some of the creators that are part of it, for the event. So similar to what Gary V has done in terms of like ticketed access, VIP entrance, free flights to wherever the events are happening, only to those NFT holders. So anyways, a lot of utility that I want to build for In the Lab, because I think, like you said, the smartest brands are getting in now, and I want us to be at the forefront of what that is going to become, especially in the basketball
space. Well, you know, it's interesting with the coins. I think, you know, you probably saw 100 Thieves. They basically had a SPAC. Like they're now traded.
I mean, FaZe Clan.
Yeah, FaZe Clan.
Right. I was like, damn, 100 Thieves did it too. Wow.
That's how I was thinking.
FaZe Clan, which is crazy.
But instead of actually going on the public market, you could also have a coin. You don't have to deal with that's another way of like
people
investing in your company and getting rewarded as well.
Well, one OG artist that does that is Pac, which is the Lost Poets that I got you into.
Yeah, I'm really happy about that.
Yeah, because he has his own coin called Ash, and it's kind of like, it's actually like kind of poetically symbolizes that when he has a bunch of projects, or I think one or two that he started, and then when you burn the project, you get rewarded with Ash.
Got you.
And then the Ash value actually went like 10 times higher than when he first started. So in a way, he's incentivizing like all his... you know, people that liking his stuff is to be part of this ecosystem and his project. So anyways, there are people doing that already. So
I guess to me, what was the moment that kind of, what was the catalyst for you to be like, you know, Web3 is the future? What was it that was the moment where you're like, you couldn't stop? And maybe it was Top Shot, and maybe it was getting into Top Shot. But when did you have the recognition that Web3 is the future?
So Top Shot kicked that off, which honestly, I would love to talk about that later because we haven't talked about Top Shot in a while.
Yeah.
There's a lot of things going on. But anyways, Top Shot kickstarted that. But in the last, whatever, it's been like 6 months or something.
Yeah.
It's been like a bull market. Everything's been crazy. And everything has come to the forefront of like, we're seeing Ready Player Me. Like we're seeing like what's happening in the metaverse. We're seeing events happening in Decentraland. So I think like, I don't think for me it was just one thing. It's just been the last 6 months, this culmination of like what's been happening and the market of Bored Apes selling for millions of dollars, 20 millions at Christie's and like Gary Vee with V Friends. Like I just got to understand what's happening better by seeing all these projects come out. But I think Top Shot kickstarted it because it was like our introduction to like what the heck is happening and what the future is going to be.
Yeah. Yeah. What about for you?
Yeah, I think like I remember you talking about Top Shot and I just didn't understand it. And then I know you talked a lot about NFTs and it didn't really make sense. I think when I jumped in the Discord and then I saw the liveliness, like this.
Yeah.
I want to say community. The community is extremely strong. And I was like, this is interesting. I didn't understand. It's, you can't really feel it or touch it. Like a physical thing, you're like, wow, I have a collectible that is worth this much. And then like yourself, when I started seeing like, wow, so just a couple months ago, this Bored Ape thing, you could have bought it for $300 and now it's over 150K. That doesn't make sense to me. Like, why didn't I not look at it earlier? Or, and then you're like, but it doesn't make sense. And then the more I just started like looking more into the projects and me just buying these random ass projects. And then I was like, being able to sell some and make money from it. And you're like, oh shit, this is legit.
Yeah. You know, I think what did it for me, obviously Top Shot was like a gateway drug for me. I think it was seeing how you can get incentivized by being like, there's this site called Mirror, and then, you know, it's really like a publishing platform, like a Web3 kind of publishing platform. Yeah. And then Colin Samir, that's what they did to mint their NFT. Yep. And the idea that you can split like the NFT with all your co-collaborators, and then the people that shared it were also incentivized and it's built into the code. To me, that was like, I was shaking. I'm like, I mean, obviously you could potentially do this through Web2, but you need like everyone's PayPal account. You need to, like, it's just like, there's a lot of complexities, but to do it so seamlessly, to me, that was like, holy crap. This is it. Yeah. Like, this is the future. It just makes it so easy. Right. By the way, did you guys get your domains?
I was just going to bring that up to you.
I haven't yet.
So yeah, did you get your tokens?
So I have a whole bunch of domains that I bought.
Oh, you may have like $100,000.
I think just this week has been crazy.
Yeah.
And I know I've made like probably $40,000 because I have like
at least three or four.
I have five like domains. 100%. I might have even more. I was just buying a whole bunch.
Yeah.
I have seancanungo.ens. I have Canungo. I have like Run. I was looking for Kanye. I wanted to get Kanye, but somebody bought it at some point. And then I just started buying a whole bunch. Anyways.
You're a genius fact. Because you put me onto that, which thank you, by the way. But it's like, that's the next layer of utility. No one knew the airdrop was coming. Then they airdropped all the holders past a certain date, tokens. Those tokens end up being worth 10 to 50K. And the market is going crazy on them right now.
Yeah.
Because I think they're pumped like 40X or 4X or something since then. So imagine you get an airdrop for, you spend a couple $100. And it's worth
And it was so cheap because, you know, if you want your domain, basically your domain name for like till 2026, it was just like really cheap. I'm like, oh, yeah, I'll just do this forever, right? And then I was starting to look up, like, can I buy Drake? Can I buy Kanye? So I actually, in my calendar, on October 18th, that Kanye was supposed to like expire. So literally set a calendar date because I wanted to buy that day that it expired. I want to buy Kanye and just like tweet out, hey, Kanye, have it. I won't sell it to you. You can have it for free. I just want to let you know that, I guess his name is Ye now, but.
That would have been amazing if you had that.
Dude, hang on. For the people who don't understand, what are you talking about? It's not a domain name like a website.
It's an Ethereum
it's
domain.
It's your
name.
Wallet. It's like your wallet, it's like your crypto wallet
address. Just to clarify for the viewers.
Yeah, no. It's your crypto wallet.
Normally your wallet address is like letters and numbers, like 1,000 of them.
Yeah.
Now it's Navin.eth, Sean.eth. Yeah.
Because traditionally your address is just like all these letters.
So now it's very simplified, and that's what you're going to be known for, to send money in Ethereum. And
you can buy those.
Yeah.
So. Yeah. Well, listen, we had a lot of fun today. Any last things? We're way past time.
Well, Beeple just sold his Human One for $28 million.
He's on Jimmy Fallon
yesterday. So this world is coming fast and furious.
Let's go.
And I think it's the future. You just got to have to jump in, taste a little bit, and then see, like, be imaginative.
I love it. Yeah. I love it. I love it.
Jump in. Next year is going to be a big year. 2022. I'm excited to see what's
going to happen. 2022. Let's do it. Mazin, any last words, my man?
Send us home, Matt. Oh, he said no.
Okay. Okay, boys. Thank you guys so much.
Appreciate it as always.
Peace.
Awesome. Now, do you want to do your thing sitting, or do you want to do